Hi and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to create a product catalogue in Word. We're going to customise some text boxes, then we're going to save some time by copy and pasting those text boxes. We're then going to place that text inside some coloured boxes, align everything, then we're going to go ahead and insert our product photos, ensuring they're all identical and exactly the same size. We'll then go ahead and insert a feature image and some graphics. And then we'll make sure everything's completely lined up and insert our hyperlinks. So let's get started. So I'm going to do this as efficiently as possible. So I'm going to insert the text first. So if you go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Click and draw out a text box. And then I'm just going to insert my text. And from here, I'm going to edit the text. So I'm just going to select it all, go to the Home tab, and then I'm going to increase the font size to 52, press Enter. And then I'm going to change the font to Bodoni 72. And then I'm just going to move this box out so I can fit all the text in the way I want it to look. And then finally, I'm going to go up to this icon here to align all the text to the right. And now I'm going to pop that up there. And if I deselect this text box, you can see we've got this black borderline, but we've also got a white background as well. So I'm just going to get rid of both of those so everything's transparent. So select the box again, go to Shape Format, go along to this icon here, Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline. Then go to Shape Fill, again, click on the drop down and select No Fill. Now, if I deselect, you can see now we haven't got that black border and we also haven't got the white background, but you won't be able to see that just yet. Now we've customized this text box, we can simply copy and paste this for the rest of our brochure. So the easiest way to do this is to select the box, hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag, and it will copy out another box. So for this one, I'm going to change the font size to 18. So I'm going to click twice and put my cursor inside the box. Press Command or Control A to select all of the text. Go to the Home tab. I'm going to select 18 as a font size. And then I'm going to simply copy and paste some text in and move that across to here. I'm not going to be too fussy about the alignment at the moment because we can come and customize it all at the end. The next thing is again to copy and paste this text, and I want three types of text boxes down here for our products. So in here I'm just going to select product name or type in product name. It's going to be centered to the box by clicking on this icon here, and then I'm going to reduce the size of it to 11. Now, if your cursor is already in the box, if you make any changes up here, it won't apply the changes. You've either got to select all of the text or deselect the box, reselect it, but without your cursor being inside, then go back and make that change. I'm going to just change the text to 11 or font size 11. There we go. And then fully customize this box, because don't forget, we're going to make six of these boxes for our catalog. I'm going to produce another one of these, copy and paste again, holding down my Alt or Option key, clicking and dragging, deselect it and reselect this box. And then again in here, I'm going to select all of this text. I'm going to paste some text in. This one is font size 10.5. It's exactly the same font. And then I'm just going to move the side of this box so that we only have two lines, just to save a bit more space. Then finally another box, and we're going to put in our price. And once again, select this and go to the Home tab. And for this font, I'm going to choose 20 and press Enter. And then we can reduce the size of that box. Now, once I'm happy generally with the layout of this, I'm going to make sure it's all perfectly aligned. So select this box, hold down your Command or Control key and select all the other boxes. Go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down, select Align to Center. They'll all be aligned to the central boxes. Then you can also go to Align and use this Distribute Vertically icon. And that means there'll be equal distance between all of the boxes. And once you're happy, go to Group and select Group. And now that's one element. Once I've done that, I'm going to go back up to Insert and I'm going to go to Shapes, click on the square and just draw out a square. To change the color, I'm going to go to Shape Format. I'm going to go to the outline and take off the outline. Go to Shape Fill, and I'm going to select this very light grey here. And then I'm also going to go to Send Backwards so that it's behind the text. Then I'm just going to reduce the size of this slightly. I may need to come back and do further adjustments and then just move this box down. I'm actually going to select both the boxes, select the text, hold down my Command or Control key, hold and select the box, go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down, select Align to Center, and that will perfectly center the two elements. Once I've done that, I'm going to select both elements by holding down the Command or Control key and clicking on both of them. Go to Shape Format, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. Now all I'm going to do is hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag out another box, deselect it, reselect one of them, click and drag out another box. And then whilst these two are selected, I'm going to hold down my Command or Control key and click on the third box. Go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and select Distribute Horizontally, which means the gaps will be the same. Then go to Align once again and select Align to Middle. And then finally go to Group and select Group. And then once again, we can hold the Alt or Option key down, click and drag out another one of these groups. I'm just going to move this up slightly and just move this down. Then I'm going to select them both again. Go to Align and go to Align to Center. Go to Group and select Group. Now these boxes are one group, we can go back to Align and select Align to Center, and everything will be perfectly lined up. Once you've done that, we can go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down, and you can select from any of these options. The likelihood is that you want to pick your pictures from your files, but for this demonstration, I'm just going to use stock images. So in my stock images, I'm just going to use the search bar and select pink food. And from here, I can just select any image by clicking on it and select insert. Once you've inserted your image, select it, go to picture format, go along to wrap text, click on the drop down and select in front of text. This will enable you to move the image. Then we're going to crop it square. So we're going to go to the crop tool, go to aspect ratio and select 1:1. Then we can move the image to where we want it. I'm going to then press the return key, and then I'm going to go back up to the dimensions here, change the top one, ensuring that this is checked, so we maintain that ratio, press 5 and press enter. And then we can just pop this image into this box here, roughly at the center, but we can come back and align those at the end. So I'm going to go through, I'm going to select all of my pictures and do exactly the same, making them all square and size 5 centimeters. Now I'm going to crop this image to a circle. But in order to have a perfect circle, I need to crop it to a 1:1 ratio first. So go to crop, aspect ratio 1:1. Line up your image, press enter. Then go back to crop, crop to shape, and then select circle. If you don't crop it 1:1 to begin with, then you will end up with an oval shape. So I'm just going to move that up to the top here. And I'm going to go to this icon here that says send backwards, click on the drop down and select center back. So it's now behind everything, including the text. Then finally, I'm going to insert a rectangle. So insert, shapes, rectangle. And then I'm simply going to click and drag out a rectangle. And then again, I'm going to go up to the top here, no outline, shape fill and select a color. And then again, I'm going to go to center back, send backwards, click on the drop down and select center back, and we'll just keep that there for now. Right, now we've got everything inside our catalog, we need to go through and ensure everything is aligned correctly. So first of all, if we go along to these pictures, so I'm going to select the group here with all the grey squares, go to Shape Format, go along to Group, click on the drop down and select Ungroup, and then go back up and select Ungroup again. So all of the rectangles are now individuals, and then select the picture, select the grey square, go to Picture Format, Align, Align to Center, and do the same with all of them. And then just select all of the images, just go back up to Align, and then Align to Top, and then all of that at the top here will be perfectly aligned. And so what we need to do is to just select everything, holding down that Command or Control key, go to Group and select Group. And we're going to do exactly the same at the bottom, Align, Align to Center. Once they're all aligned to the center, we'll just select all of those three, Align, Align to Top. And then again, select all the grey boxes as well, go to Group and select Group. Then we can go to the top one here, and then make sure they're all aligned to the center, those two groups, and then Group and select Group. And now we're just going to move this down, and then we can move this image up, and then this text we can move up slightly. Okay, so now you've finished your design, you may want to have some links where you click on the description or the picture and it will link through to a different page. Let's say you've got this on a website and you want to create some links. If we just ungroup everything, go to Picture Format and ungroup everything, just keep ungrouping until everything is individual parts. So if you want your customer, consumer to click on this box here, you can select it, right click, go down to Link, and then you can put your link in here. So let's say I pasted in the link to my YouTube channel and then click OK. Now, if I was to just click on this, you can see that my YouTube channel appears. And if you're to export this, let's go to File, Save As, go down to the bottom here and select PDF. Then we can save this as Catalog. And then you can select either of these. If obviously you're using some online services, it's best to click this option here and click Export. So if I now open my catalog in my PDF, you can see this is what will be displayed. And if I click on here, if I hover over this first box here, you can see that the cursor changes and there's actually a hyperlink in there. So if I click on it, you can see once again, my YouTube channel will appear. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.